All right, hey Virgo. So we're doing your monthly moon read. This is going to be for March, and it is going to be themed as the other two reads for January and February were themed. So if you don't resonate with the theme that comes through, check your other placements or check any video that you feel drawn to, considering this is a moon read. All right. So I'm going to pull a tarot and we're going to get the theme. If you guys are new, welcome. I do hope that you subscribe if you like my energy. And you guys, look at this. I mean, if the reads have not all been major arcana, okay? The theme, the High Priestess, powerful psychic insights, reflection and meditation that provides valuable information, and you're being told to be at peace. Let me move this guy. All right, so you're coming through with the High Priestess. That right there is like authoritarian, it's unattainable energy. You guys putting yourself first above anything else is kind of what I see with that. It could be that you're tapping into your spiritual roots. It could just be that you're making yourself unavailable to those that don't treat you with respect. You know what I mean? I love the High Priestess that she comes through because she is divine feminine energy, and it could just be that you know your worth, you know your value, and that is the embodiment that you've been carrying. Okay, and it could be too that you guys are wondering how to achieve the next level. So this read, it could be very it could be about money, it could be about love, it could be about your spiritual journey, your gifts, your magic, it could be about anything. So just keep an open mind when it comes to the dynamic here. We're gonna start with the full moon. Okay, the full moon represents clear perspective or letting go. That full moon comes through March 7th. All right, so let's see what is highlighted for your full moon. I'm going to pull that one because that's the one I've seen. And then we're pulling just all sorts of oracle cards. I like oracle cards. So we're going to pull some oracle cards, clarify it with the tarot card. Okay, so what you guys have coming through with the full moon, I can't help but feel like it might be just a little bit on the side of letting go. Clear, getting a, yeah, letting go. Talk less and feel more. Okay, look at that. Talk less, feel more. Attachment, longing, desperation. And then we have the Ten of Gabriel. Ask your angels for helpful people and try to lighten your load. Working too many hours or trying too hard to please others. Okay, wow, I don't know what is going on with this, you guys. I'm so sorry. I didn't know it was fuzzy, you guys. I'm sorry about that. I hope it's clear now. God, I'm gonna have to pay attention to that. So the full moon, talk less and feel more. It could be the way that you're talking to yourself. It could be the way that you're talking to somebody very near and dear to you. You guys could have somebody weighing on your heart. That is that divine feminine energy. Okay, it could just be, how is this going to happen? How is it going to come all together? How am I going to make with this person? How am I going to make it work? But look at that attachment. You're holding an attachment to an outcome. Okay, and I can't help but feel like if you guys have found that you're on some sort of a soul journey or a twin flame journey, we're called to detach from that, because what we're supposed to do on those journey is learn about ourselves. Okay, we're supposed to heal and grow and repair the past traumas and woundings of relationships. And I can't help but feel like you guys might be carrying an attachment style that we're used to, but you got to understand that the deeper soul level connections that we make, they're not going to be like those ones, okay? But in order to have that divine union, what we have to do is go within, and we have to start to heal and repair how we think and process, especially matters of the heart, okay? I mean, this does not have to be a love read. It could be an abundance read. It could just be that, you're blocking your own blessings by not sitting and feeling, all right, the emotions that you need to be feeling, especially when it comes to the vibration. So the vibration, the higher our vibration is, the easier it is to call in what it is we're wanting. Okay. So I mean, I just can't help but feel like this is tying into somebody that you guys just are incessantly thinking about, obsessively, incessantly. It doesn't matter. We've all been there. So there's nothing wrong with that, okay? But I feel like you guys are truly being called to let go of the outcome of the situation, especially when it comes to a person that you just cannot shake for the life of you, okay? So with the last quarter moon coming through on March 14th, I can't help but feel like we're kind of rolling into the dynamic of shedding, okay? So as long as you guys take the as long as you guys, I feel like what happens with these reads is as long as you take the energy, you take the advice, and what we're gonna do and what we're gonna see is a full scale circle to what is coming back on our heart space, okay? But you know, it's kind of important to start somewhere, and I feel like you guys, you just might be talking in your head too much. It might be time to clear some space, especially negative thoughts and emotions, because what happens when you can clear the negative thoughts and emotions is you're making room for brand new energy to come through to you. Okay, you got stepping out of your comfort zone. All right, this is definitely going to be shedding. The Great Gathering, it's all coming together, intuitive hits and soul tribes. So maybe step away from the dynamic of this one person. Okay? Because I'm just going to go right back to there. Just step away from the dynamic. Step away from what you feel you think you know. All right. I feel like, yeah, the soul tribe coming through, and you got the Page of Gabriel, energetic, brave, optimistic, and playful. Shedding. You're shedding this. We're not going to be sitting on outcome, you guys. We're not worried about the outcome of anything coming together for us, especially in when it comes to matters of the heart. Okay, what you guys are being told right here is to be in pursuit of the spiritual journey. So if you guys were awakened and activated by somebody, okay, that person triggered you. But I feel like some of you guys might be ha or have stepped away from what your true the true connection was. So if this person activated you and say you started doing tarot or Reiki or crystals or runes, and you stepped away from that because you were too, it was like motivated by this person. The reason why there's a disconnection is because you're supposed to be motivated into what your calling is. Right. I kind of can't help but feel like maybe you guys have stepped away from something that you're passionate about because you're giving somebody or allowing somebody to take away from you, which tells me right here that there is going to be a huge balance of feminine energy that needs to come through here and the release of codependent behaviors. Okay. You guys are being told to connect and start finding some soul tribe, especially if you guys have a twin flame journey that you cannot speak to about with regular people because they don't understand it. They give you bad feedback. Okay, don't talk to those people anymore about this dynamic, okay? So with that being said, let's move to the new moon. Okay, so this is either going to be a fresh start or a healing phase. The new moon is March 21st, so let's get our backups. Okay, let's get our backup cards. Oh, this is all about fresh starts, man. I feel like by the time you guys hit to, by the time we get to that the mid-month, look at that, the Three of Michael, Three of Swords coming through right in reverse. So you're definitely healing and you're stepping into the fresh start dynamic. You're being told to go for it, and you got achievement coming through. Competition, completion, excuse me, and reward. Okay, so look, we step out of our ho-hum drum, right? And then we step back into who we were when we were activated, or when we kind of started to awaken by this meeting, this interaction. Okay, I cannot help but feel like you guys right here, you're being told to, hey, wherever this dynamic woke you up, okay, wherever this dynamic woke you, step back from it a little bit. And what you're being pushed to do is no, go back in. You're not done yet, okay? You haven't served your purpose yet. And true, you know, if I'm gonna tell you, if you're on a soul-based relationship, twin flame, whatever you guys want to call it, if you know that there's something higher that brought you and this person together. Okay, what I feel with this very deeply inside of my heart is you two are meant to come through and share these gifts together. But if we're so worried about somebody not catching up, or we're so worried about somebody pulling away from us, that is defeating the purpose of this journey. Okay, it doesn't matter if you guys believe in twin flame or not. It could be that you believe in a soul-driven purpose with somebody. It could be, just be that you believe in soulmates. It could just believe that you don't believe in any of it. But why is this person different? Okay, in your soul, there's something that there is difference. There is a difference with this connection. And I feel like your soul journey, it's like you're gonna find out what this is when you travel back to the soul. Okay. So let's see what the last quarter, the first quarter moon brings to you guys. A look ahead, or are we making decisions? Okay. Look at that. You guys are definitely looking ahead. All right, a time for healing. Okay, that's the decision you make. And then you're already doing it. Stop overthinking, keep facing your true north and closing out a cycle, a very happy ending coming full circle, spiritual growth and insight. Okay. And even if you guys can't see it through this read, I bet you anything by the end of the month, you're going to see everything that this read is talking about. It's going to get you back to where you were without having the need for somebody to tag along or catch up, right? Okay, so we're going to look at the gifts that your lunar return is going to bring you this month. Oh, yeah. I mean, I just love how synchronistic all these cards can just blend together. The reason I'm saying, oh, yeah, is because you know what? The root portal coming through. Okay, when we fear attachments and the here, the now, the world, the worldly energy, look at this vitality, stability, survival, and fearful. So what we're going to do is we're going to transition from survival and fearful mode to vitality and stability. You also got the star card coming through. The silver energy of the star brings good luck and serendipity. Okay, I cannot help. I just love it, you guys. So the root portal could actually be telling you guys that it's time to do a root chakra balance or a cleanse when it comes to that root chakra. Okay, so let's just see. I'm going to tie this all up for you guys. Let's tie it all up. Okay, so if you guys have been questioning your path with this person, I'm going to tell you this. Okay, how often do you see the divine feminine and magician show up together? Okay, so if you've been worried that this person is not the one who's supposed to be in your life, you're wrong. Okay, you're wrong for worrying, but you're right that this person is meant to be in your life. But that's divine pair right there. These right here are divine feminine and divine masculine energy. Okay. You can manifest the life you want. What you will need will magically appear in successful beginnings. Okay, this person is already in you. They are you. Okay, so I can't help but feel like it's a divine masculine feminine energy update, but it's for somebody who has kind of retracted and stepped back away from the actual journey itself. Okay, you have the Three of Gabriel, prosperity arising from wise planning. Take time for the next step. Optimistic plans that turn out as expected, but you guys have to get away from whatever it is, whatever that fear-based energy was that I see right now. The Page of Raphael, gentle, loving, dreaming, open-hearted, a new emotional situation, messages regarding relationships or social invitations, and great intuitive insights. Okay, so I feel like the full circle right here is so you knew you or you've known this to be something very important, and I feel like it's a situation with a person. The biggest thing you're going to want to start doing is healing the old dynamic, okay, the old thought patterns, but also too, we're going to learn how to balance the masculine and feminine energies. I can't help but feel like that is what needs to be done here in your case, very specifically your case, okay? Balancing those actually starts to bring everything into perspective. Oh, okay. Virgo, I'm going to leave it here. You guys take care.